This is part five. We are solving quadratic equations by completing the square. We do the following two problems where the coefficient of x squared is not 1 on this video. This is part five. We're going to continue solving quadratics by completing the square when the coefficient is not 1. So here's another example. We have 2x squared plus 5x plus 4 equals 0. So since the coefficient of x squared is not 1, and it's an equation, we could divide everything by that coefficient of 2 so that we can get an equation with a 1x squared. So there we are. We have x squared plus, now what do we have here? 5 halves x. Now I'm going to put the constant on the other side, so I'm going to leave my blank right here. And 4 halves is the same thing as 2, so I'm going to subtract 2, put a negative 2 on the other side of the equation. And we have plus a blank. I think I need to move this over a little bit. Okay, so that's how we want to start out. All right, now what do? Well, we have to think of what's going to go in the parentheses, so that if we made this a perfect square trinomial, what would be in the parentheses? So we've got x squared, that's got to be an x, this is a plus. We need half of this coefficient. Now if you can't do that in your head, go over here and think of that. What is 1/2 of 5/2? Nothing cancels, you're going to get 5/4. So that's exactly what we would have in here, 5/4. So if that's 5/4, then we're going to square that to figure out what would be added to both sides. So when we square 5/4, we get 25/16. Right, so that's what we're adding to both sides of the equation. Well, some people get confused with these fraction bars, so if you'd like, you could make this a box to show what you're adding to both sides. If that's easier, use a box instead of a blank line. Okay, now we need to simplify this right hand side, so we're going to have to get a common denominator of 16, so I'm going to do that down here at the bottom also. That would be negative 32/16, that's how you could write negative 2, plus 25/16. So if you have a common denominator, you just add the coefficients, that's negative 7/16. So you have negative 7/16. Right, so I was just doing that scratch work. And now we're ready to go. We've got something squared equaling a number, so we could take the square roots of both sides. That's the square root property. So that we have x plus 5/4, and always remember it's going to be plus or minus. All right, what do we have going on over here? Well, we've got the square root of negative 7 for the numerator, so that would be square root of 7i. Remember, when you have a square root of a negative number, it's a square root of the non-negative part with i over 4. So now let's subtract 5/4 from both sides to solve for x. So we have negative 5/4 plus or minus square root of 7i all over 4. Now, it's all over a common denominator. Oops, here it is. All over a common denominator. So I could just write negative 5 plus square root of 7i all over 4. Or you could leave it as negative 5/4 plus square root of 7 over 4i if you want to write it as a complex number, a plus bi form. And negative 5 minus square root of 7i all over 4. So two ways you could write the answer. And there we go. All right, we're going to do one more problem. 2x squared minus 3x plus 5 equals 0. Try this on your own first by putting the video on pause. Okay, we've got a 2x squared, so we have to deal with that. Let's divide everything by 2. So that gives me x squared minus 3/2 x, and then we're going to add something to both sides. I'm going to go ahead and use a box this time, equals, And on the other side, we're going to have a negative 5 halves plus whatever we add to the left side of the equation, we'll have to write to the add to the right side of the equation. All right, so what would go in here? Well, to get the x squared, we need x minus, and I need half of 3 halves. Can you do that in your head? 1 half times 3 halves? Nothing cancels. It's 3 fourths. So 3 fourths squared is what I add to both sides. So 3 fourths times 3 fourths is 9 sixteenths. That gets added to both sides of the equation. And now on the right-hand side, I need to get a common denominator and add. So the common denominator is going to be 16. So I'm going to write that down here. If I have negative 5 halves and I want to make it 16, so I just multiply by 8 over 8 plus 9 sixteenths. So what is that going to give me here? I'm going to have negative 40 plus 9. Everybody with me? Negative 40 sixteenths plus 9 sixteenths. That's going to give you, sixteenths. Made a mess of that. That's going to be negative 31 sixteenths. So the right-hand side simplifies to negative 31 over 16. Now we're ready to use the square root property. Take the square root of both sides. So we have x minus 3 fourths equals, all right, again, we're taking the square root of a negative number, so it's going to be a complex number. It's going to be plus or minus, don't forget the plus or minus, square root of 31 I all over, square root of 16 is 4, okay. At least I have a common denominator here, fourths on both sides. So we just add 3 fourths to both sides. So my final answer is 3 fourths plus square root of 31 over 4i and 3 fourths minus square root of 31 over 4i, or you could write it over as a single fraction, 3 plus square root of 31i all over 4, and 3 minus square root of 31i all over 4. And there. There we have it. Let's see if you tried it on your own. Hope you did it right. Remember, there was the original up here, 2x squared minus 3x plus 5. And equals 0, and those are the two solutions.